Up to the ES5 standard of JavaScript, there were only two scopes, that is the global scope and the function scope within which we were defining our variables. Starting ES6, we have a block level scope, just like other programming languages like Java, .NET. The keyword let can be used to define block scoped variables. Let's see the difference between using var and let and how it saves us big time. Go to your text editor. Create a new file. HTML is the root element. Inside HTML, we are going to use a body. And within body, define a script block. Save this. I'm going to save it under my documents, new folder ES6. And the name of it is let.html. Let.html is the file name within which define a function. Call it let demo and use var I is equal to 10. Let's see how var works first. Use a for loop. I is equal to 0. Var I is equal to 0. I is less than or equal to 20. I plus plus. Do a console.log of I. Console.log of I outside the for loop. So here we are defining two variables. One right inside the function but outside the for loop. So this has a scope of the function. And here we are defining a var I again inside the for loop. In other programming languages, you would expect that this I is only visible from here, starting the for function body, and it ends here. Let's see if that's true by looking at the result. Invoke this function, let demo, right after the function body. Go to your folder ES6, wherever you have saved it. Let's make sure I am saving it under the right folder. Save as ES6, let demo. .html. Now, if I go back, open that in the browser, go to the console. You can go to the console from View, Developer, Java Console, or you can use the shortcut Command Alt I on your Mac and Command Shift I on your Windows. But what is important here is the output. It starts from 0, goes all the way to 20, as expected from the for loop. But here, you would expect that the value of I would be 10, but as you can see, it is 21. So that's how the var keyword defines a variable. If you use var, that means it is available for the entire scope. In this case, that scope is function and not just this for scope. That is the reason you are seeing 21, because it uses I. Here we are redefining the value of I to 0, although it is assigned to 10 here. At the end of this for loop, I is 20. And at the end of the for loop, it is 21 because that is when the for loop stops. So I is being used as 21. The value of 21 is being used as the value of I, which is not what we want. We want it to be 10. So if that is the expectation, use let. Right here, if you use let instead of var starting ES6, then this I is available only for this scope. And this I here refers to the variable that we have defined up top here. So save it. Go back to the web browser. Refresh. Now you see what you expect. It works. The for loop displays all the values up to 20. But then the value of that global I remains 10. This is very useful, especially if you are using multiple loops. In programming languages like Java, this is a common practice where you use multiple loops like this. And every time you start a new loop, you define that variable again, which will be only for that scope. So if you use let, it will be available only in that scope. If you try to access something which is defined within that scope, outside of that scope, it won't work. For example, within this for loop, I'm defining let x is equal to 10. Now, if I try to access x outside of this for loop, console.log x. Save it. back to the web browser, hit enter, and it says uncaught reference error, X is not defined. That is not the case if you define it as var. If you use var, X is equal to 10, go back, refresh, you still get the value of X, because whatever is defined as var, it is automatically hoisted to the function scope or the global scope. But that's not the case with let. Let always belongs to that scope within which it is defined, and it is not available outside of that scope. So let brings in block scope.